Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Greetings from College Dunya. I would like to inform our viewers that Dr. Anup Faltode, sir, is the head of career guidance and counseling cell of KDK College of Engineering, Nagpur. He has completed his PhD from RTM Nagpur University and has an experience of over 25 years. We are extremely delighted to have him on our leadership series, Thoughtful Leaders. Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
So, sir, as the head of career guidance and counseling cell, can you throw some light on the genesis of the college and briefly explain the vision and mission of the institute?
Yeah, actually, career guidance and counseling cell was started in 2015. Basically, the idea behind starting this was, since I was in charge of admission cell, many parents along with the student used to come to us for say guidance or counseling, but actually that time we didn't have any dedicated cell for this type of guidance. So I saw that many students as well as parents also, they were a bit confused because they didn't have the enough knowledge, or you can say that the information, and you know that basically the students, they are more motivated, or they are they decide their plans and their goals as per their friends, because friend circle is more dominating at this particular age, and parents want something, students want something. So I thought that why we should not have a dedicated cell for this type of guidance, wherein we can guide parents as well as students, looking at the student's interest as well as parent interest and the current scenario also, because it's not like that I want to do this, then only I have to do this. But actually, we have to see the perspective also, that if I am going to be graduate or engineer after 4 years, so what will be the scenario that time? So what will be the requirement of market? What will be the situation at that time? That we have to vision. First, we have to have the vision of that, and then accordingly, we can sell it. So that's why we started with this. And vision of the college also is same. Service to the society through quality technical education. So KDK College of Engineering, as you know, that it has been established in 1984. So more than 36 years of experience we are having. As you know, that I am also there in KDK for so many years, 23 years. So it's a very old and reputed institution. So every time our objective or motive is to give the best possible technical education, not only technical education, but at the same time, guidance and required counseling also, because the students, though they may graduate, but still some guidance and counseling is needed at each and every step, and that what we are doing.
That's really great to know, sir. Sir, as the head of counseling cell, can you throw some light on the admission process, like end-to-end admission process?
Yeah, actually the admission process, I have to say in simple words, so basically it consists of 4 stages, but this process, whatever I am going to discuss right now, is still last year, because you know that due to the pandemic, corona pandemic, this year a lot of changes are bound to happen. They are in pipeline. Technical Ministry of Maharashtra government as well as AICT, the apex body, they are working on it, and right now nothing is clear. So it would be very, you can say that, difficult for me to elaborate what would be the process this year. But till last year, what used to happen, broadly speaking, the admission process can be divided into 4 stages, as I have told you. First will be the examination, entrance examination, because when it comes to the admission, as far as Maharashtra is concerned, without any entrance examination, you won't get the admission. That means on the basis of 12th, you won't get any admission in Maharashtra. Here, either you have to appear for JEE Mains, or you have to appear for the Maharashtra CET, which is conducted by Government of Maharashtra. So actually the first stage would be appearing for the examination. Then second stage comes after the declaration of results. Second stage is registration for CAP process. CAP means centralized admission process. In Maharashtra, the admissions to all government colleges as well as all private institutions are done through the centralized admission process only. Okay. So registration is the second phase, wherein student have to register himself or herself on the website which is designated by the Government of Maharashtra, and you have to put in all your details, your category, your parents' income, so that you are the benefit of category you can be entitled for. Then third stage is option, that is you can say that the filling the choices of the colleges, and this is the very crucial and important stage as far as the whole admission process is concerned, because here if you do not take the proper precaution, and if you don't fill the options properly, then you may land nowhere, or either you may not get the admission, or you may get the admission in some college where you entirely don't want to go. But actually here at this particular point also, it is very important that proper guidance is very, very important. And while selecting the colleges, you have to see certain factors or parameters that when I choose this college, these parameters should be very, very crucially and critically seen that they, that particular college qualifies or stands on these particular points. First would be placement, training and placement, because what, after all, what is the aim behind taking the degree in technical education? That I want a good package, I want a good placement. So that is very, very important, that what are the placement. Second thing is that what is the infrastructure, because infrastructure has to be there so that all the facilities that are required for creating a good technocrat, that is very important. Then third very important thing is that what is the academic, or you can say that teaching learning process, which is, and results of the college. And fourth very important, and rather I would say last but not the least, but the most important thing is that whether that college is accredited by the apex bodies like NBA or AICT. Because nowadays, as far as Maharashtra government is concerned, scholarship or freeship means that government which gives scholarship and freeship to the minor students of various categories is given only if the college is either accredited by NAC or by NBA. But as far as engineering college is concerned, NBA is more important, and I feel very proud to say that our institution, that is KDK College of Engineering, has been accredited for all the courses by apex body, that is National Board of Accreditation. So this is very important. So most of the student, they don't know this thing, and they actually don't bother about this. And the particularly most important thing is that they don't have the knowledge. And when later on in the month of December or January, when it comes, that college says, "Hey, your scholarship form has been rejected." Why? They don't tell the student that why your form has been rejected, because they know that their college is not accredited. So how could they get the scholarship? So this is a very important parameter factor that student have to keep. And the last option, the last stage or rather fourth stage in the admission process would be the admission to the allotted college, where the student, suppose you got the college allotted of your choice and you decided that, okay, now I want to join this college, then in that case you can freeze that option, that college. Once you freeze, lock kiya jaye, jaise Amitabh ji kehte karodpati mein, so you can freeze that option. And once you freeze that option, that means you are out of process now, you can't attend the further rounds. And then whatever college you have has been allotted to you, and once you freeze it, you go to the college, get your admission done by paying the fees, and you have to submit your document. So this is the brief of the admission process which have been carried out till last year. But as I have told you, because of this pandemic, still examinations are postponed many a times. Right now you must be knowing that JEE has been also postponed. It will be now from 1st to 6th August. Our MST CET, which was scheduled for from 4th to 5th August, that has been also postponed. Dates are not declared yet. And NEET also, because this is, NEET is going to be conducted for all the students for dental courses and medical courses. So therefore, what would be the admission process this year? Nobody is certain. The authorities, they are working upon that. Once we get the confirmation, we can let the student know about it. Okay.
That's really great to know, sir. Sir, you spoke about the scholarship, freeship, and various other facilities provided to the students by the government. Sir, can you throw some more light on that? Like what other facilities or what other facilities like are provided by the KDK college?
Yeah. We will do one thing. We will divide into two parts. One, government scholarships, and other is KDK scholarship, or you can call it a sponsorship also. So basically, the government of India, central government, we can call it, and state government, that is government of Maharashtra, as far as KDK is concerned. So in Maharashtra, there is a policy of scholarship and freeship for various categories, which come under reserve categories like SC, ST, NT, SBC, OBC, and VJDT. Now here, what is done, there are two different words. One is scholarship, other is freeship. A scholarship is entitled to those students whose parents' income is below that particular limit which is set by the government. For example, if I give the example of say OBC. So if your student is OBC, belonging to OBC category, he would get scholarship if his parents' income is less than 1 lakh. But if OBC student is there and his parents' income is more than 1 lakh but less than 8 lakh, then in that case he would get the freeship. Similarly, for SC category student, if his parents' income is less than 2.5 lakh, he would get the scholarship. And if the income is more than that, then in that case, he would be getting the freeship. So, scholarship is granted by central government and freeship comes from the state of Maharashtra. And both of them have some, you can say that proportion, contributions. State government have some contributions, central government have contribution. And if the student have all the required documents, that means caste certificate, caste validity certificate, and in case of OBC, NT, SBC, VJ category, the non-creamy layer certificate, that means parents' income is not more than 8 lakh. That means they don't fall in the creamy layer. So all these documents, and in Maharashtra, one more thing I would like to add, because none of the college would tell you about this, because this is very critical as far as the scholarship or freeship is concerned, that in Maharashtra, particularly for OBC, NT, SBC and VJDT, the government approves scholarship or freeship only to those students in whose family first or second child is there, or government would give you scholarship or freeship only to two child per family, whether it may be first or second, maybe second or third, or maybe one or fourth also. But in that case, you have to make it very clear that the second and third number, your brother or sister, they have not taken any benefit of scholarship. So this is very important and critical. And we observed that during this process of admission, that some of the colleges, they don't give the detailed information. They only, their objective is to get the student admitted. And then later on, so you know that. So, but we hanky-panky. So we don't do that type of hanky-panky in KDE College of Engineering. Everything is clear. Now, students say, particularly a student from general category, they said, okay, sir, you said a lot of scholarship and freeship schemes are available for reserve category student. What about us? What about general category, or we call them as open category student? So actually, basically, open category student also get a benefit under the scheme known as EBC, economically backward class. The meaning of this is that if I belong to a general category or say open category, and if my parents' income is less than 8 lakh for the previous year, for previous 3 years, then in that case, I am also entitled for the EBC scholarship, wherein student would get credited to his account 50% of the tuition fee of that particular college, means as good as OBC. So this is the advantage that the open category or general category students have. But most of the students, they don't know this criteria, because previously the criteria was only 1 lakh for general category, and very few people were eligible because of that criteria. But during last 3 years, now this criteria has been increased to 8 lakh. Maybe because of the implementation of 7th pay, it might happen that government, central government might increase it. But right now it's up to 8 lakh. At the same time, this is as far as the tuition fee is concerned. And apart from this, government of Maharashtra particularly have the schemes of hostel facility also for SC/ST as well as open category students also. Where for SC, it is Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Swadhar Yojana, wherein suppose a student from say Bhandara or Amravati, he studies in Nagpur and stays in private hostel or even college hostel, or it stays in a room rented. In that case, suppose he don't get admission to the government hostel and he has to stay either in private hostel or college hostel or rented room, then in that case, if the parent's income is less than 2 lakh, then in that case, student would get 5,000 per month plus 5,000 first year for your stationery and books allowance. So that means almost 60,000 particular that student would get. Same scheme is available for ST category candidate also under the name of Pandit Dindayal Upadhyay Swadhar Yojana. And for open category or rather general category student also in Maharashtra, the scheme for staying in the hostel, private hostel is also there. If a student belonging to general category, suppose his parents' income is less than 1 lakh, and if his or his father is a farmer, not having more than 2.5 acres of land, and if income is just, I told you, is less than 1 lakh, and if he stays in private hostel, then also he would get around 30,000 rupees from the government of Maharashtra towards his hostel reimbursement. So these are the various schemes. Then for minority students, that is Jain, Parsi, then Sikh, Christian and Muslims, so they also are entitled for a scholarship known as minority scholarship, which is granted by the central government. So around 25,000 per year, again, the criteria is that parents' income should not exceed 8 lakh. So this is also another scheme of scholarship which is available for the minority students. So these are the government scholarship. As far as KDK is concerned, so under the name of our late founder chairman, Bhausaheb Mulak, we are having a scholarship scheme wherein those students who qualify a certain criteria, that depend, the case to case it may vary. According to that, we grant some scholarship from college itself and management reimburses that. Suppose I want to take my education, I want to continue, but the financial situation is that it don't permit me to pursue my education, technical education. And if suppose such student approach us, and if we see that really his situation is like that, he or she cannot pursue the education because of the financial problem, then in that case, apart from their scholarship, they are getting from government, college itself has certain fund allocated for that, and we grant. And last year, almost there are 600 students who are taking benefit of this Bhausaheb Mulak Protsahan Yojana. Actually, the name is, we are matlab, encouraging them. That's why this name is there, that late Bhausaheb Mulak Protsahan Yojana. So this is the scholarship, or you can say that financial assistance, which has been offered by the KDK College of Engineering Management.
That's really great to know, sir. So you spoke about the uncertainty in the admission process. So when is the next batch expected to commence, and what would be the safety measures be taken?
Right now, you just I told you that the examinations which were scheduled in the month of April 1st, they were there, they were postponed due to the COVID, and then they were rescheduled in the month of July. That JEE was scheduled between 18 and 23rd, NEET was scheduled on 26th of July, and our Maharashtra CET was scheduled between 4th July to 5th July. But now, as you know, that the JEE mains has been shifted to 1st to 6th August, NEET also has been postponed, and Maharashtra CET dates are not yet declared. And it is assumed that since the examination, that is entrance examination, if they are conducted in the month of September, so naturally, if you have to take the examination during such time wherein you have to maintain the physical distance and all other things, so then in that case, the span of the examination also would be more. Because if you have to accommodate so many students, for example, Maharashtra CET, MST CET, if you consider more than 5 lakh students have registered all across Maharashtra. So in that case, we have to have many centers. So that will be a very, you can say that a big experiment on the part. And because these examinations are postponed, so we are having very less time for the, and it is a semester pattern. So for first semester, it will be very less time available. So according to that, the government is planning, and this year it might happen that the stages in the admission process, they would be modified so that student need not go to the center. Previously, what used to happen, every time student has to go to the one is called as facilitation center, where he has to go, he has to get his documents attested and you can say that verified, authenticated. Then he has to go to the ARC, admission reporting center, where he has to accept the seat that has been allotted to him. So that used to take a lot of time. Okay, but I think that this year, because of this, there will be a cut, or you can say that cut down in the duration of the admission process. So uncertainty is that when we are going to start and how will be the admission process. But as per the news and as per the various input that are there, so I think that admission process won't start before the last week of September. It don't seem possible before that. Even it might happen that it might be postponed because if the situation worsens, because we don't know, because you know that daily the number of patients, they are increasing day by day. So so everything is, you know, that uncertain.
Rightly said.
If at all, when the admission process will start, we are ready with all the equipments, and we are ready that every precaution is taken that student do not get any infection or affect, they do not get affected when they come, because we have got installed the auto sanitizers at every entrance in the college. Then we have got sanitizers available in the offices wherever, and mostly this year we will have the paperless, you can say that the procedure, admission procedure, our admission forms are available on our website. Student can go there, they can download it, they can fill it, they can make it PDF and they can send us. Okay, and all the documents, they are already uploaded online. So at the time of coming to the college, they would submit a bunch of the documents, original documents, and then by taking proper precautionary measures, we will get them verified. And at the same time, the fees also student can pay through online mode. Already they have been activated on our website. So whenever the admission process will start, we have made it very sure that student owned or parents will have no problem at all. All the safety measures and precautionary measures that has been the guidelines, rather you can say that has been coming from various authorities, we are adhering strictly to that.
That's really great to know, sir. Sir, how diverse is your current batch of students in terms of gender ratio, and what measures you take to ensure there's no disparity among them?
Actually, the advantage with KDK is that that can be our USP also. Our institution is the only institution which is situated in the heart of Nagpur city. Okay, and it is connected by all parts with bus and all other facilities. So the advantage is that in KDK College of Engineering, the gender ratio is, you can say that, around 50-50%. We are having a lot of girl students in engineering college, because since it is in the heart of the city, so many parents, they prefer KDK College of Engineering being an old institution at the same time. But other advantage is that since it is in the heart of the city, it is very convenient for them to go to the college. They need not unnecessarily have the expenses of bus and all other things. And as far as the, as you say that the, how the disparity or discrimination. So actually in KDK College of Engineering, if teaching staff is also considered, if you see, look at the staff. So in staff also, we are having almost same ratio, gender wise. So therefore, and we have got women redressal cell, then we have got women development cell, and wherein various activities are undertaken, and we have got other platforms also like NSS, National Service Scheme. There also we have got 50% girls quota reserved specifically so that girls are also there. They are participating in various social activities. Then we have got student forums at every department level wherein girl students are given the posts, wherein like secretary or vice president or like that. So every time we make sure that the girls do not feel that we have been considered as a inferior, you can say that. So every time, whatever activities and whatever programs we are arranging, not only this as far as co-curricular and curricular activities, but when it comes to the curriculum also, since mechanical engineering, as you know that mechanical engineering is dominated by boys or male candidate, but if you come to the KDK, you will see that there is almost 40% girls taking education in mechanical engineering, and by choice they have taken mechanical. So that is the advantage. So in this way, we encourage both boys and girls to undertake various activities. And as I have told you that we have got women redressal cell and women development cell also, wherein various activities pertaining to their health and other issues, and sanitary napkin vending machine, and all these activities. And moreover, we have got our medical college also in our premises. So lady doctor is deputed every time we have various health issues, health checkups and all these things. So this way we make it sure that there is no discrimination. Everybody is encouraged, and if you see the merit list also, girls are always at par with the boys, and that is only because of the encouragement that has been put in by various staff, faculty members and management.
That's really great, sir. Sir, what would be your suggestion to the students who are aspiring to join your college?
Okay, suggestions, I would say that just now, previously also I said that selection of college is a very, very important, you can say that, stage in the admission process. Once you miss the bus, miss the train, so you may land, you know that. So as far as KDK is concerned, this college, as I told you that it has got standing of 36 years. Secondly, heart of city, then accredited by Apex bodies, then training and placement. If anybody wants to check our training and placement, they can go to our website. Even during lockdown also, we had online placements, and I am very proud to, I feel very proud to say that 595 students of previous batch has been placed, and many of them have already joined, irrespective of the thing that they have not got their degree, because examination has been either cancel or there is no right now what exactly is going to happen. But companies don't wait, because companies are started, particularly software companies. So many people have joined, and we have got a very dedicated training and placement cell, which is supported by CRT. That is a unique, you can say that is campus recruitment training, because we know that company requirement is something different and what curriculum is catering is something different. So in order to bridge the gap, we have got this, you can say that campus recruitment training, wherein we impart training to the students so they are ready to face the challenges in the industry. And you can say that company also get the ready-made product, that is student, or you can say that the technocrats. So then as far as the results are concerned, results are also very good. Every year you will see that, suppose if I say that final year merit list is there, there are suppose 10 merit declared by university, almost 50% students will be there from KD College of Engineering. So in this way, so I would suggest them that while selecting the college, you have to see all these parameters, and KDK do fit in all these criteria. Plus we have got various skills. Like this year, one more question is that particular concern, rather I won't say that is a question. The concern is that finances has gone down because of the COVID situation. So parents might find it difficult to pay the fees or like that. So in that case, we have a tie-up with some banks for providing the education loan. We have got the counters of those banks in college itself at the time of admission process. And then if student require, then installment facility is also provided to the student. So whatever is good or better for the benefit of the student, all these things are taken care at KDK. So therefore, I would suggest them that you can join the institution which is going to develop you all round, so that you would face no problem while getting the placement. And this is my assurance as a head of the Career Guidance and Counseling. And still, if they have any type of doubt or difficulty, they can come down to my office. But actually, I won't suggest right now because of this COVID. Of course, they can come with due precautions, and they are most welcome if they want to join the KDK, that is the premier technical institution of Central India for 36 years. They are most welcome.
That's really great to know, sir. Sir, what would be your message to the students and parents ahead of this uncertainty for the next season?
Yeah, actually, I'm planning to prepare separate video for this, because during last week, I had a discussion with some of the parents and students, wherein I saw that not only students, but parents also are panicked. They are because clueless what exactly is going to happen. So actually, my message to them would be, they need not panic. Actually, this is a phase. Everybody has to, okay, but this is the unpredictable, and that's why we were not prepared for that. And the situation is not getting under control as we were expecting. But that doesn't mean that this is the end of the road. Actually, this is like situation, suppose you are driving on a during winter, wherein there is a lot of fog ahead of you and you can't see anything. So what we do at that time, we take a halt, and then we let the situation clear. Once the road is clear, we move ahead with that. That doesn't mean that you are going back, you go back. So this is same there. And I want to say that I want to say tell student that you have got the additional advantage of this time. You have to utilize this time. We can have more practice. Some of the students, they are saying that, sir, we are going to take the drop, or we are going not to, we'll prepare it again, and this year we are disturbed and like that. But I would suggest them that every year now, since you have seen the pandemic and it has resulted into, you can say that, unemployment. So if you drop 1 year, that means you are lagging behind almost 4 to 5 lakh students. From, if I talk about Maharashtra, they would be going ahead of you. Means your competition will increase next year. So that is always better. This year you have to prepare, and you have to take it positively that I have got extra time. It's okay. The students are saying, sir, we are doing it. We have been doing it for last 2 years. And that's why, because we are not free till date, and there is no certainty what's going to happen. So you have to take it positively. Do meditation, and don't pay attention to unnecessarily negative YouTube videos or news, and don't listen to the TV or like that, where every day there's a lot of discussions are going. Simply focus on your studies. Not necessarily that throughout the day you should study. Now, since you have got so much time, you can take some out, take out some time for your refreshment, and you should play some games, meditation, some yoga, and you make a timetable. And if you follow that, definitely we are going to overcome this situation, and you are going to definitely come. That would be my stay positive. That is very important.
Rightly said, sir. We should not listen on noise so much. Sir, right. This discussion was really very insightful. I'm sure the viewers will learn a lot from this. Thank you again for your time, sir.
Thank you very much.